talking to myself and feeling old. Sometimes I'd like to quit, nothing ever seems to fit. Hanging around, nothing to do but frown. Rainy days and Mondays.
Well, before the cup, I kind of let him speak a bit. I'm speaking a little bit choked, yeah, so it just feels a bit boring.
I had a disappointment, suicidal thoughts. I'm exaggerating, but it was pretty hard to take after the expectations of the country were, you know, so high.
Now we move on to the final quarterfinal of the weekend just gone. A game where New Zealand, the mighty All Blacks, took on France, in Cardiff, of all places. The All Blacks, raging hot favourites, and they,
Who do you think is to blame?
Who is to blame? It's got to be the team. It's got to be the team, yeah. Oh, no, I don't really blame them, but...
I think the coaching has got a big part to play.
No, the French just played out of their skins.
The 2007 Rugby World Cup result was a unique one for New Zealanders. There was the devastation of previous years. Barlet Campese in 91, food poisoning in 95, French flair in 99, and that intercept in 2003. There was seemingly no one to blame. It could be argued that the referee was to blame. He was certainly crucified by the New Zealand media. But that didn't change the fact that our rugby gods had fallen to earth early in the tournament, beaten by an average French side. There is no doubt that today was a dark day for New Zealand sport. But out on the streets, I still felt a sense of optimism. It may be a myth that our rugby players are invincible. But the positive, she'll be right Kiwi attitude is anything but.
I'm sure we'll get over it.
Yeah.
Hopefully the suicide rate won't be too high.
And do you think that we can ever win the World Cup?
Oh, sure.
I hope so.
Yeah, I don't know when, but yeah, I'm... You can never count your chickens before they hatch.